That was quite the performance from Jose Berrios.
Well, he backed up the last one. Might have even been a touch better in that, you know, I just think it was a little, maybe even a touch more dominant. But all the things that we've asked him to do in terms of trying to help him, you know, find success at this level, he's been trying to address, and it's showing up so far in his first couple of starts. You don't want to get too crazy about it yet, but to throw as many strikes as he has and getting ahead as many hitters as he has and just attacking with his fastball, we're seeing, you know, is staying true to his alignment, which keeps him from backing up pitches. You know, he hit a couple guys early in the game on a backup breaking ball and a fastball he tried to get in, but pitched around the small trouble that he had. I thought the throw him out on the missed hit and run swing was a big out for us, but he got deep in the game. You know, I got to a situation there in the eighth inning where we kind of had to make a decision about how to get those last four outs, and thankfully those guys made it stand up.
You mentioned the strikes. I think 106 pitches, he threw 72 strikes. Is that just a different kind of confidence?
Well, it's what we've been stressing with him to be able to maximize, you know, kind of the giftedness that he has. Is you know, you pitch from ahead up here, it just makes the game that much easier. So that's a really good percentage. You know, we'll get a chance to break down, you know, fastball, curveball, change, and see how they add up in that as far as that category. But overall, that's a really good percentage.
Was his breaking ball a little more impactful today in terms of kind of fishing off you guys?
You know, he used it. You know, we saw him freeze a couple of guys and, you know, get a couple of expansions on it. I just think that the fact that he was getting in a good spot more times than not, they were having trouble, you know, knowing what to look for. I mean, you know, the guy's throwing hard, and he had a little extra gear when he wanted to try to put somebody away with the fastball. And, you know, that breaking ball, when he can command it down and away like that, he's going to get some funky swings.
What did they have to play like Kepler? I think it was a second. It was a nice.
Yeah, it went a long way. You know, he's got the ability to do those type of things. I think he's still maturing into a guy who, you know, trusts his athleticism, and but that was just one of those plays where it goes up, and you know you got to just kind of turn your back, and hopefully you run to the right spot. But he went a long way. It was a good play.
Jose, do you think it's confidence that leads to command, or the other way around?
I think it's probably a combination, Jim. I don't know which one precedes the other. It might change from start to start, but you know, just being able to come up here and get off to a good start. We talked about, you know, the difficulty of expectation and, you know, always hoping that the next time you get a chance, it's going to be the right time and you can run with it. And, you know, a couple of big starts against a couple of really good teams in Cleveland and Colorado. So, you know, that kind of adds to the positivity surrounding what he's done so far.
The timing of this game.